A caravan of approximately 3,000 migrants leaving Tapachula in southern Mexico is heading to the U.S. southern border. The group of migrants is made up of people from Venezuela, Ecuador, Colombia, Peru, Haiti, Costa Rica, Panama, Nepal, Afghanistan, and Central America, La Verdad reports. The migrants are hoping to make their way to the United States before President-elect Donald Trump takes office on January 20th. As the migrants make the trek, some say they're leaving their countries because where they're from is dangerous. They have no security or job opportunities to support their families. Cartel violence, high unemployment, and economic crises in South and Central America are driving more people toward the United States. A caravan.
Immediately upon taking the oath of office, I will launch the largest deportation program in American history. I will rescue every town across America that has been invaded and conquered. They've conquered our country. This is an invasion of a military force. They have weapons that are on par with our U.S. military. But we will put these vicious and bloodthirsty criminals to jail or kick them the hell out of our country. Ideally, the second, because we don't want to have to pay for the cost, so we'll ideally bring them back to their country immediately.
We're also following several major developments in the border and migrant crisis after the election. Mexican officials say a migrant caravan of thousands that was headed to the border is starting to break up and turn back. In fact, Newsweek reports many of the roughly 3,000 migrants abandoned the caravan and turned back fearing deportation after getting word Trump had won. Also, a federal judge ruled against the Biden-Harris administration's plan to fast-track permanent residency for illegal migrants married to U.S. citizens. And New York City Mayor Eric Adams ending a controversial program that gave taxpayer-funded debit cards with up to $350 a week to illegal migrants in the Big Apple. We're going to have more about the migrant crisis ahead in our next half hour. We're also...
Mayor just announced that the city will no longer issue vouchers to migrants to pay for food, ending a controversial program that had repeatedly come under attack by conservatives and others.
But now its absence may raise even more questions. The so-called Immediate Response Cards pilot program was designed to help feed migrant families who'd found themselves in New York with no way to afford food. The one-year contract provided what the city described as culturally relevant food to 2,600 migrant families, allowing them to basically buy what they wanted. A family of four with two kids under five got about $350 per week to cover food in a program the city said would actually save taxpayers millions a year. It also reduced food waste. For more than a year, the city was groaning under the weight of more than 200,000 asylum seekers. Officials say the migrant population has actually reduced lately. In fact, a massive shelter on Roosevelt Island is in the process of closing. In the meantime, Mayor Adams spoke on the phone yesterday with President-elect Donald Trump, who had vowed during his campaign to mass deport migrants.
Mayor just announced.
Migrants, along with immigration advocates, gathered tonight in Foley Square, where they expressed fear over Trump's campaign promise of mass deportations. Fox 5's Kendall Green has more.
Hundreds of immigrant advocates packed into Foley Square to rally with signs and chants.
No hate, no fear. Immigrants are welcome here.
And a spirit of resilience against an incoming Trump administration they've had battles with years before.
While our movement experiences setbacks, we will not be silenced.
Aparicio is an immigrant from Mexico, among hundreds in the crowd, sharing since election night he's had worries for him and his loved ones.
It's really boring for me because when I came to this country, I was hoping to find opportunities for myself and my family. With Trump, it's going to be a little harder.
Mayor Adams earlier this week admitted the city has struggled to balance the overall rhetoric and balance its budget due to the influx of migrants.
The pressure of finding billions of dollars instead of going to those needs that everyday New York is needed.
Migrants.
Do you see all undocumented immigrants as should they all be kicked out of the country?
Some conservative estimates say that there are at least 15 million illegals who have come into the country on Joe Biden's watch. It's my hope that we deport every single one of them that we can. And it starts with deporting violent criminals who are in the United States, who came here illegally, who have committed violent crimes. And I think once you do that, President Trump is committed to making that his first and top priority when it comes to mass deportation. And then also on top of that, increase the penalties on businesses who hire illegals in our country and take away the incentive for them to be here and for them to come here. And I think many of them will leave on their own. But this the mass deportation plan needs to be an immediate focus of the House and the Senate, I believe.
Donald Trump has promised the largest deportation in American history. We know he'll start that process on day one, but it's not so easy to deport millions and millions of people all at once. He said he will call up the military and government agencies to help him do this. He's also vowed to build detention camps and invoke the Alien Enemies Act of 1798, which would allow him to expel, kick out alleged cartel members without a court. Court Trump doubled down on his immigration policies throughout his campaign and during his victory speech last night.
And on day one, we will begin the largest domestic deportation operation in American history. We're going to fix our borders. We're going to fix everything about our country. And we made history for a reason tonight, and the reason is going to be just that.
All right, News Nation Southwest correspondent Allie Bradley is live in air.
Donald Trump has promised a mass roundup of millions of undocumented persons who would be taken to detention camps like Japanese-American civilians were during World War II, and then rapidly deported. Trump would end the so-called catch-and-release policy, under which asylum seekers fleeing violence or persecution in their home countries are allowed to stay in the U.S. pending their immigration court hearings. Trump plans to hire thousands more border agents and redirect military funding to border security. He says undocumented migrants are criminals and psychotics.
These are seriously sick people. And no, I don't want them in our country.
Trump wants the death penalty for undocumented aliens convicted of killing U.S. citizens and would invoke a 1798 federal law to expel without trial suspected drug traffickers or alleged members of criminal gangs. Trump has said he would remove tens of thousands of immigrants who are in the U.S. legally under temporary protected status, like the Haitian residents of Springfield, Ohio, he has accused of eating household pets. Donald Trump.
Tonight, News Nation's Allie Bradley's in the Del Rio sector of Texas. On their way there, her team ran into smugglers trying to cross with a group of migrants last night. Border correspondent Allie Bradley joins us live from Shelby Park in Eagle Pass, Texas. Allie, tell us what happened.
Yeah, hey, Elizabeth. So, you know, we've been doing this kind of three busy sectors in 3 days following the Trump-Vance victory. And what we experienced last night was quite possibly the scariest part of the leg of the trip. And quite frankly, some of the most unsettling experiences I've had along the southern border. So we want to show you some pieces of video and kind of walk you through what we experienced here in the El Paso sector, which is where we ended last night. This is a Sunland Park area. This is actually technically New Mexico, which is part of the El Paso sector. So we wanted to see how the cartel is operating out there. Have things changed? What are they doing right now? Well, when we were up there, we actually hiked up a bluff along the border with Mexico there, and human smuggling is rampant. The wall just ends. It's pretty much a free-for-all, wide open. So we're walking back down, and we see these three men in all-black clothing with backpacks on. We didn't know if they were going to cross into the U.S., but they absolutely went and walked them with their route pretty quietly. We ended up meeting them at a bend in the road, literally coming face-to-face with them, quite literally stopping them in their tracks. So they chose to run instead of engage with us, which, you know, we were lucky for that, but we did alert Border Patrol that that was happening, and we followed them down the hill as they continued to evade law enforcement. But just as soon as that happened, I turned around, and this man pops up on the Mexico side, right on the boundary line, and he's holding an AR-style rifle, and he kind of shows it off to me, kind of, look what I have. I have this rifle here. Don't mess with us. Waves us off as we're recording, and he walked back into Mexico. Now, law enforcement tell me he was likely helping those individuals that we saw running off into the bushes.
We're here in Nogales, Mexico. This is one of the biggest shelters on the Mexican side of the U.S.-Mexico border. As you can see, many migrant kids are waiting here with their families for a chance to enter the U.S., and they are using a system that the Biden administration set up through a smartphone app that allows them to request a time to enter the country legally at an official border crossing. But now, many of these children's parents are growing increasingly concerned that President-elect Trump is going to end that system and that he will seal the border altogether. And so there is a lot of uncertainty, fear, and concern here in northern Mexico.